Rescue efforts are underway right now here at Mount Ontake in Japan, and I want to show you what's happening close to the summit, because in addition to the rescue activity, seismic activity is also underway. You see that white plume that's rising from the mountain? That is a series of small eruptions that have continued ever since this major eruption on Saturday just before noon. And if you look over to the right, see that mountain there that looks like it may be covered in snow? That's not snow. That's volcanic ash, just to give you an idea of the volume of ash that's spewing out of this mountain and raining down on the surrounding area several kilometers around, and also raining down on those mountain lodges where hikers who are injured and unable to get off the mountain are still hunkering down waiting for rescuers to get to them. Because of the size of the ash cloud, it's difficult for helicopters at times to get close because the ash could cause problems with the aircraft. So we have hundreds of teams, members of the Japanese Self-Defense Force, firefighters, volunteers who are hiking up three different routes of the mountain, 3 kilometers up, to get to these people who are injured and physically carry them down. But in addition to survivors, we also know that there are victims, some 31 people who were near the summit at the time of this eruption, who it is believed did not survive. They were found in a state of essentially cardiac arrest, meaning their hearts have stopped, they're not breathing, and once they're brought back down to the mountain, a medical examiner will officially pronounce them dead. So far, a handful of people have already been carried down and pronounced dead. And that is a process that sadly will continue here at Japan's second highest volcano. And it's a process that takes on new urgency because smaller eruptions are happening, and seismologists say an even larger eruption, another big one, could happen here in the coming days. I'm Will Ripley in central Japan.